We're back here again in the Deep Space Habitat mock-up at Johnson Space Center, talking with Sarah Schull from the Logistics Reduction and Repurposing Group. Kind of a mouthful, but it basically means taking what you have and making something more useful out of it, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So we talked last time about the cargo bags, and this time she has a different project to show us. Tell us what that's called again.
So this is another aspect of the logistics project, and it's called the heat melt compactor. So it's a project actually led by NASA Ames in conjunction with our team here at Johnson Space Center. And they're looking at, so you generate all this trash in space, then you know what can you do with it to save volume, compact it down, kind of like a terrestrial heat trash compactor. Mm-hmm. The crew could load their trash in, and then it compresses it down. It also heats it up, and it'll make these bricks. So these are tiles that were made in the Gen 1 unit out at NASA Ames. This one has kind of office trash in it.
Procedures, I guess, and tape and gauze.
Gauze. There is some plastic material in it. That's kind of what holds the tile together and keeps it from springing back, like a terrestrial compactor might do. It heats the trash up hot enough that it does sterilize it. So if you have food residue in here, it'll stop the microbial growth, stop the odors. So this tile is just, like I said, kind of office trash. This one is actually shuttle trash. So we took some trash that we were able to get from STS-133, sent it out to Ames, and they compacted it down for us. So you can
Actual space trash,
labeled as critical space item. It does do a 95% reduction in volume. So if nothing else, you buy back that volume. So
how big? I guess, would the trash bag be to make that?
So this, again, would be a 95% reduction. So if you kind of multiply this by 20, that's how big it's going to be. So if you can picture this stacked up, you would maybe, like a printer paper size box full of trash. So then we're also, as part of Logistics to Living, which we talked about earlier, looking at what can you do with these tiles? So in addition to just reclaiming the volume, could you repurpose these tiles in some manner? Because there's a 20-30% plastic content in the trash generated in space average, there is some radiation protection capability of these tiles.
Okay.
So you may be able to get some additional radiation shielding for free.
So there's a few different reasons then. So you said it, first of all, gets rid of the germs.
Mm-hmm.
The heat kills the germs. Second, this is much easier to store than a big box of trash would be.
Absolutely.
And then hopefully you can not only get those good purposes out of it, but also reuse it for something else.
Right.
Radiation.
Yep.
Radiation is something we're definitely concerned about and trying to figure out.
Yeah, that's a major concern for going into deep space.
Solutions for us, so.
Yeah, so we're developing a second generation of the heat melt compactor, and the tiles are actually going to be square with just for the reason that that's easier to repurpose.
Mm-hmm.
If you've got a layer, tiles layering round, you have to have a lot of overlap to cover, whereas square, you can kind of put them end to end and get a nice coverage.
Okay, so the heat compactor, how big is that? Is that something?
The Gen 1 unit is probably about the size of this glove box if it were turned on its side.
Okay.
For the Gen 2, we're making it smaller because we know that volume is very limited in space, in the deep space hab. So it's going to be two express rack locker size, the size of two express rack lockers, which is roughly probably half the size of this glove box. So we're constraining it to be that small. We want to make sure that it's not taking up too much volume itself.
Are there other things you could use the tiles for besides the radiation protection, or is that something you're looking at?
We've brainstormed and we've talked a little bit about, you could use them to build dividers or additional partitions. The leading candidate is really additional radiation protection.
Okay.
And using the MCTBs that we talked about earlier, if folks are watching.
Uh-huh. The cargo bags.
The cargo bags, yeah. We've developed a schema that you could deploy the tiles using those bags. So you could line your crew quarters with a bag that's covered in tiles.
Okay.
And the tiles aren't real pretty to look at, so you probably want the bag covering, and that would be the side the crew would see.
Agreed, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, and I guess that's two of, I think you told me, four projects that you're working on. Do you want to, real quick, just give us a quick overview of the other two?
Yeah, so the other two tasks that fall under the logistics reduction and repurposing, one is advanced clothing. So it's actually looking at how do we reduce the volume of clothing we need to fly for the crew by extending the life wear of the clothing before it gets too smelly or, too much microbial growth. So we're looking at fabrics we use here on Earth for long duration clothing, some antimicrobial coatings.
So the idea is would kill the germs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The idea is to roughly double the wear time of the clothing, so you'd have to fly half the amount of clothing, cut down on that volume.
What is the wear time that we have now?
It varies by item. I don't actually have all of them memorized, but okay. I would say, you know, a pair of exercise shorts, you may wear them for a week.
Okay.
And so we would, if that's the actual number, we'd be looking at 2 weeks, say.
Okay.
And same thing, you know, shirts and pants, they all have different different numbers. The fourth task is the trash to supply gas. So that is another method of looking at what we can do with the trash that's generated. And that actually looks at, can you take the trash that's generated and turn it into a useful gas, like methane? So if you have a lander as part of your deep space architecture, some folks are probably familiar with Morpheus, that uses methane, could we generate the methane the lander needs from the trash?
Okay.
And that actually is run, our team members from Kennedy Space Center on that portion of the project.
Well, lots of interesting projects going on. Thank you again so much for talking with us. This again was Sarah Scholl, the Deputy Project Manager for the Logistics Reduction and Repurposing Group of the Advanced Exploration Systems Program. So we'll go back now to Mission Control Center and Pat. Thanks so much.